Hello, everyone. Welcome to Royal Randwick for the latest in Sky Racing news, and it's all around the champion mare Winx. At 3:05 local time tomorrow, she'll attempt to go out in her career as a winner. And the activity around Winx is unbelievable all around the world. Talking with Bob Baffert, the legendary American trainer today, Bob says, "I'll be nervous when she's going to the barrier, but she's a champion and she'll be winning." The Australian Turf Club are lined up so many activities out here for the whole family for Randwick tomorrow, but also if she wins, look to the sky and the track for special momentous moments around the champion mare in Winx. And as Peter Tighe said this morning, it's all around the fans when they attend Randwick tomorrow. Of course, there's others in the race, and they're probably thinking they're out to run for second money tomorrow. A couple of those, Happy Clapper. Pat Webster says we can't have the horse any better. That's also the case with Hartnell. A Kiwi mare, Dance, Dance, Dance. Avilius cleared out and simply won the Randvet so strongly the other day. But certainly Dance, Dance, Dance fought on very bravely to run third. Has made further improvement. Chris Gibbs says that if we can settle third or fourth, we expect to be running into some healthy prize money tomorrow. The all-out market has, of course, Winx not in this. He's Eminent is the favourite, the expected leader in tomorrow's Queen Elizabeth. Happy Clap and Hartnell are the second and third picks. Well, what about the Randwick track? Conditions today are continuing to be partly cloudy, but tomorrow it's going to be fine and clear.
Soft 5 at the moment, Pano 5.37. Looking at the way the weather is today, I don't know if we'll get too much of drying through today. They're forecasting a bit of fog in the morning, so I dare say it might stay there in the morning, and then with that nice fine day, I think we'll probably look at getting an upgrade during the course of the afternoon.
So that's the latest from Randwick track manager Navesh Ramdani, as we're 24 hours away from this day two of the championships. Tomorrow's Arrowfield three-year-old sprint promises plenty of fireworks, plenty of pace early. Classique Legend, with the 3 weeks between races, is very much ready to go. The horse will be brought early to Randwick tomorrow, get it into the race day stalls, take that sharpness, get the horse relaxed before it runs tomorrow. And Avant Avantage, well, it won the birthday card at its last start. Now, on this occasion, Avantage led up. It was the first time she'd ever led. And talking with Jamie Richards, the trainer, they certainly think tomorrow it would be better for her to be taking a sit and chasing the leader rather than be left out in front. Classique Legend is the favourite to win the Arrowfield with Avantage. And then you get to horses like Trope, who will be certainly finishing off strong. Well, of course, the champion mare, Winx, goes out tomorrow, but it would be a special day if some progeny of the champion UK horse Frankel won here tomorrow. Frankly Awesome lines up in the Oaks, and we've got a horse called Significance who lines up for John O'Shea in the very first race, a son of Frankel. It ran fifth on debut at Newcastle, but this trial at recently at Warwick Farm was very impressive, particularly the last couple of hundred metres. John O'Shea saying the time for the trial was reasonably slow, but he does feel that this horse has a very bright future as a three-year-old and is being set towards the spring champion over 2,000 metres later on this year, of course. Immersement, by the way, is the favourite for that first race. Significance has been $11 in, so it's been well found already through TAB at this stage. That's it for our racing news. We wish you all the very best tomorrow. It's a day to be at Randwick if you can for the Queen Elizabeth and the farewell to Winx.